Hello, I'm David Sibbald, and I've been giving enrichment talks on board ship for over 5 years now. My main interest is British and American entertainment, films, music and so forth, and in one of my talks on the BBC in the 1940s and 50s, I explore why they banned some records, perhaps because of dodgy words, but also they banned million-seller hits from Perry Como, Bing Crosby and Ella Fitzgerald.
I also offer talks with video and audio on several British singers of the 50s and 60s, including Frankie Vaughan, Alma Cogan, Kathy Kirby and Billy Fury. And as these last about 15 minutes each, I usually squeeze three into each presentation. Other entertainment topics include The Great American Songbook, featuring different composers, but it occurred to me there isn't a Great British Songbook, so I created my own. I started in the Theatre District of London, where all the American shows came over after the war. Then I look at the career of Lionel Bart, The Beatles, The British Invasion of America, The Lady Singers, Flower Power, The Psychedelic 70s, Lord Andrew Lloyd Webber, and the renaissance of the great British musical.
Carry on now, in a sec, with a song which is our record before, you know. And this one's called, Ticket to Ride.
As the record says, glad all over.
She was my woman.
The magic of Fred Astaire in the 30s and 40s shows off his many talents and the various dancing partners he had.
In us you see a couple of song and dance men.
I'm the song.
I'm the dance.
In another talk, I recall the lovely singing and acting of Dear Doris Day.
I killed about 30 of them painted varmints before they got discouraged.
Yes, there never was a glibber fibber or a cuter shooter than Calamity Jane. She could outstalk, outdraw, outride any man in Deadwood.
And seeing you here tonight, Jimmy, surrounded by so many of your friends and all of us who love you so very dearly, I can't help but wish that we were starting out to do Love Me or Leave Me all over again.
I do hate to interrupt, but would you mind hanging up, please? Who's that?
The other half of my party line. Just ignore her, she'll go away.
Oh, I miss those laughs we used to have.
Oh, me too.
I do. We had so much fun.
I haven't had a good laugh like that since.
And then there's everybody's favorite, Judy Garland. Her highs and lows are explored, but I focus on the movies of this talented yet troubled personality.
The lights are shining any place but there.
The night is bitter. The stars have lost their glitter. The winds grow colder. Suddenly you're old.
Judy got married for the last time in 1969, and just a few short weeks later, she had passed on from this world. She was only 47.
Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue.
In the world of literature, I explore the work of the famous detective Sherlock Holmes and Sir Arthur Conan Doyle.
Hello. My name is Holmes, Sherlock Holmes. It is my business to know what other people don't know.
The name Sherlock Holmes and the address is 221B Baker Street.
I smell the faint, sweet odour of blackmail.
These were two very clever people, one real and one fictitious, but both captivating.
When I talk on this subject, I'm not talking about what I believe. I'm not talking about what I think. I'm talking about what I know.
Then there's dubbing in Hollywood musicals. Often the stars we thought were singing weren't. And the film studios often did strange things to perfectly acceptable actors and singers, and I explore several of those on film. The British television series Steptoe and Son, were they a happy family? What was the truth? I give an insight into the actors' real-life relationships as opposed to what we might have read in the papers. I also have a couple of Christmas presentations looking at our favourite films and another one remembering the great Brits from British comedy television. I present two talks on Scandinavia, The Norwegian Connection and Swedish Rhapsody, both of which show several aspects of each nation through history, music and literature, travel, folklore and humour.
What are you doing, by the way?
Making sure there's no neighbour outside.
And you think that's normal?
Okay, now.
Waterloo, I was defeated, you won the war. Waterloo,
I have a look at more quirky sides of the Swedes when I visit the absolute ice bar. And to underline the quirkiness of the Swedes, do you know what happened on this day in 1967? The Swedes stopped driving on the left and started driving on the right, with these results.
Well, I hope that's given you an idea of what I present on my onboard lectures. Thank you for watching.